Alright, people. We're gonna work on color today. We got two light tones, so we wanna hit it kinda dark. I think because it's a woman, we'll do the pinks and the purples, or maybe the purple first, because it's a stronger color. And I think I'm gonna make kind of like a, that kind of shape. Oh, that's way thicker than we want it. If it's too thick, make sure you add a little water. Spread it out a little bit. You're gonna have to add some more to it. But you want it kind of runny, because that's how you're gonna get that marbling. Just start switching up in tone, lighter the tone. It might not look like it's lighter, but they are different colors. And it doesn't matter if you stay within the same, like as far as color theory, you know, you can put lighter tones next to them. It doesn't necessarily matter, because the way that they mix is going to be the way that they mix. It's, you're not really going to have a definitive answer why that the colors don't mix or why the colors do mix. It kind of just happens. Those are those beautiful mistakes that we like. But color theory is very, very, very important. Want these tones to marry together and become one. You know, you don't want them, you almost want them to just stay away from each other. It's like blending but not blending. And I already can tell that these browns are gonna do a lot of chemical reaction, because even just pouring it on there like that, you can see it start to create the cells that we all want. And I think with this kind of artwork, the less you try, the better that it comes out. You know, like, you don't want to try so hard. Just kind of put stuff. I see people and they try to make it look so uniform or like it has not purpose, but you're literally giving it the direction. We want this one to be wild. This one's gonna be crazy. I can tell already that the mixtures and just the colors, by those colors right there, that it's gonna be insane. Like I say, don't be afraid to go crazy. You know, you want those little hints and those little things that's just unorthodox. You want to add those colors in the right spots. We're gonna try out this new blue. See how it kind of marries in there with that. Maybe add some darker blue somewhere else. Or even adding this blue. I love this, like, real funky. It's like a real navy. And then we'll do the teals and the sea foams right here, because I love the way that these colors meet. They come together so well, and they blend so perfectly that always make sure you got pokers to clean out. And you can put these colors, it doesn't have to necessarily match or have even the same color theory. You know, sometimes that unorthodox color looks really cool, like introducing like the greens in here, or even introducing the greens up here. You know, the lime greens and the, not that color. We want kind of like a funky. Yeah, you gotta make sure that before you start, maybe making sure all your bottles are clear. I hate when I get in the zone and my bottle doesn't work because it's clogged up with paint that's dry. I don't put tops on my bottles because then it just, it's just another step that kills you from that creative process. You know, like this, like literally having to take the cap off and get out this gunk is stopping my creative process. But now we need to do some oranges and yellows, so we'll do the oranges, and I almost use it like a battle, like what colors are going to fight next to each other and look really cool. That flavor, because if you don't, you know, you always want to overdo it as far as making it look visually. I mean, unless you're going for the real simple look, then that's fine, but we don't do simple. You want to stand out, you got to go above and beyond. I think that's it, but I think I need another color right here just to break up. Even if it is like for textures and for cells, because I think we'll get quite a bit of cells. The more we add to this. Okay, that's it. Now, this is where the magic happens. I usually don't explain it this into the in depth this much. You guys are gonna see how and why this stuff happens the way that it does. When you are creating the abstract, you want to brush over it. You don't want to put the palette knife down and do this. You literally want to feather it and kind of just gradually stay on top of it. And make sure you have something to clean your palette knife off of. Textures and it will start to morph and change as the time goes by. You'll see the cells starting to form, and like I say, you want it to be organic, So don't try so hard. Feather it right on top. Maybe pull some of that lighter tone. Maybe pull some of those light purple dots. Crazy, the better. You know, it just looks better. And I'm gonna go around. I don't wanna do this. I want everything to kind of marry. So, no, actually, I want this to be on top of this. Try to have some kind of structure for your piece. Have a kind of where you, what kind of direction you want to go before you start doing it. Strokes and how you want it to lay out. And the more loose you are with it, the better. You know, because that's where you get those true. It takes a little bit of that finesse to get those blends and those colors the exact way you want. So now we'll go to the other side. Like I said, you don't want to touch it as much. So the less you touch it, the better. And I can see that these browns are going to have some crazy cells. I can see it already. I always love the way that these colors marry. I mean, this looks, oh my, oh, wow. I mean, when you're talking depth, the browns and the reds just, I mean, it's unprecedented. Like, it's crazy, the life that these things have. And then, like I said, make sure when you're transitioning from those colors that you make sure that you clean off that palette knife, because you don't want to keep creating the same color, because you'll end up starting with colors and then end up with brown if you're not careful. Man, this is organic. I mean, this right here, bam! I love when it works out right, you know? See this. Wow, this is, I don't even know what to say. But you can see less brush on top, push it. You know, you want to be real, real smooth with it. You don't want to push all the way down and then have that stroke, and you don't want to keep touching it. Here with the, we'll add some more purple, some of this purple, and then what we'll do is we'll add that brown, because because it's a lot of really cool textures going on. So we'll add this brown. I only have much left of it. But you can see that the more you do, the solider that it's gonna look, and vice versa. That's the cool thing about it. Add a little bit, take a little bit away. You know, that's the awesome thing about this is you literally can, you can always add, you just can't take away. You know, just wanted to fill up a little bit of that space because it looked... Took a nosedive. Damn. Okay, well. That's what I get for bumping into stuff. But, that's it, guys. But look at this thing. Some intense cells. The chemical reaction on this one is insane.